Welcome everyone to Gamer Meld. Today's video is strictly gaming news, and hopefully you like it, but of course, if you all prefer just gaming hardware news, I'm happy to not do it again. But I've been following this Metro Exodus fiasco pretty much from the beginning, and I figured I'd do a video overview of everything. It all started early last week when Metro Exodus's publisher Deep Silver announced that the game will not be available on Steam at launch. That doesn't sound too bad, right? Well, get this, it was already on Steam for pre-order. Sure, they're gonna honor those pre-orders, but the move to exclusively release on Epic Store was clearly a last-minute decision, leaving those who pre-ordered on Steam left in the dust. And it actually gets worse. The game will go on sale for $50 on Epic, making the biggest fans who paid $60 from Steam feeling even more screwed over. So why is the publisher doing this anyway? Well, that reason is somewhat understandable, and it's how they're able to offer it at a lower price. Epic takes a much smaller commission than Steam for each game sold on their platform. We're talking 12% for Epic and around 30% for Steam. Now, that may not seem like a huge difference, but for AAA games, it can amount to tens of millions of dollars. And this actually leads me to the biggest issue gamers have. Epic's new store doesn't have any kind of review system in place for owners of the game to give their take. So gamers are, in my opinion, rightfully angry about the one area we have control over. Basically, it feels like Epic cares way more for developers than they do the gamers. I mean, could you imagine the kind of crap horrible games could put in and still sell well because no one had a way to let others know? Obviously, we do still have reviewers on things like YouTube, but the average consumer typically just looks at reviews right there. Due to all these issues, gamers seem to have been review bombing their older games on Steam. And keep in mind that review bombs are another reason publishers don't want reviews. But personally, I think it's the consumer's right to be able to say what they feel about a product. And while it's a little dishonest to review something based on things other than the product itself, and really as long as a reviewer is honest about why they gave it a bad review, it's just the public making their opinions heard. So this finally leads me to the most recent controversy, and it's been everywhere on the news. After the review bombs, the developer for the game seemed to threaten gamers that if we boycott, the sequel won't be on PC. At first, I was really pissed off, but while I'm still pretty upset, I've read translations from Russian speakers and those who were saying it's not a threat, and I do get that.
It was simply the developer's personal opinion that if all people cared more about revolting against Epic and Deep Silver than about Metro, it wouldn't do PC gamers any better in terms of getting Metro on their hands.
He's more or less stating that if the game doesn't do well, it won't make it to PC, which is somewhat true. And when you read the full post, he's basically a developer that's quite upset that the game he poured his heart and soul into is getting all this hate. Plus, he's only a developer, so it's not like he can truly make that threat. But if we're honest, that's still an absurd argument in the first place. Simply put, if the publisher doesn't change what they're doing, the gamers who don't buy this game won't buy the sequel anyway. And if devs don't put it on PC, it means they got poor sales and gamers somewhat won. Though the goal is, of course, to get them to listen to consumers. But if gamers are boycotting the game, they don't want a sequel. And if the publisher is too stupid to listen to their user base, to which sure, many of those who are mad may not have planned on buying it in the first place. But you better believe that many of them were. And if the threat or promise or whatever is that they won't get the sequel on PC, so be it. But don't tell me that won't hurt the publishers ultimately either. Anyway. With that said, in the final story so far, Deep Silver today went on record to apologize for what the developer said, and to reassure us that potential future titles will always be on PC. Unfortunately, they're still making it pretty clear that they won't be changing anything as far as going back on Steam, so we'll have to see what happens. Of course, that's just my opinion, but I'd love to hear yours. Let me know what you think about the whole situation down in the comments below. And if you like the video, definitely make sure to subscribe. And as always, have a great day.